Previously on My Summer Car.
Was that smoke coming from the hood, or was it just dust from the ground? Well, it doesn't seem to be on fire. Good night, and welcome back to My Summer Car. Okay, drunk guy just called. It should be around 2 a.m. And, yeah, it's 2 a.m. Let me just grab a pizza. And some water. I want to take the van actually, because then I can pick up the scooter. Where is the van? It's too dark. Here's the light. Didn't I just park the van? Here? Uncle, take it back. Well, I guess I'd just take the Satsuma then. Either way, I now have vehicles with passenger seats, so I can actually go and pick up the drunk guy. Sure, I parked the van here. Okay, that's not good. That's not good at all. That kind of looked like something burning. Let's see if this needs topping up with coolant or engine oil. Yeah, it did need a little bit of coolant. And a little bit of engine oil. Yeah, this is kind of bad, isn't it? Can't see any flames. According to the instruments, there's like nothing seriously wrong there. Okay, let's just see what happens if I try to drive. there's nothing wrong with the way it drives. If I start seeing like anything going awry with like the gauges and stuff, I'm just gonna stop. No problem there. Could be a busted head gasket. If that's the case, then the car will start overheating because it'll burn all the coolant. It might burn all the coolant, or depending on how that head gasket is broken. If it's like broken in a way that a coolant passage like leaks into the engine block or a cylinder, then it will start burning. If coolant leaks into a cylinder, it will start burning coolant. If coolant leaks into like the main oil gallery, then you'll get water in the oil and it will turn into like a milkshake looking sludge. But if it's just a cylinder venting pressure out of the engine block, then you'll get lots of smoke, as I have here, and lack of power, but... I wonder what happened to the van. I know the uncle takes it back after a while, but it had just been like a couple of in-game hours. Yeah, when I get some more money, I might just leave that Flitaris for a while and ask him to do like an engine checkup. I don't think it's too expensive. Should be less than a thousand, I think. I think the drunk guy just waits outside the pub until we get there. Which is good, because it's like 3 hours in-game since he called me. Well, the car hasn't burned to the ground. Yeah, that's the drunk guy. Hey guy, you gonna get in or what? Dude, come on.
Säkin kotiis.
Voi vittujen kevää!
Dude, you just called me. Wait for the bus to pass me. There. Just had to get closer. Did you? There we go. Let's get you home. My wife constantly... Whoop! The fuck? Freaking bus driver. It's a good thing I know where this guy lives, because he's not saying anything. He's just drunk. Actually, I could have just taken the highway. Doesn't matter. Yeah, I could have taken the highway to Lapa. Then turned onto the dirt road from there. Yeah, this is the guy who's gonna buy my moonshine. Yeah. I think my plan is to just get this guy home, then take this car to Futari and figure out what's wrong. Or actually, I don't have any money. This guy might pay me. I don't know how much, but he might. I think it's random, actually. He might give you just pocket change or an actual sizable sum of money. Here's my tractor, where I left it. He's somehow still awake. He's been at it since 2 a.m. And this is his house. $50! Thank you, it's nothing. Well, let's get it to Futari and maybe whatever is smoking some arts is something that can be fixed. Like, if it is a head gasket, then I don't think it's too expensive. I'm thirsty.
Terve, terve!
Terve, terve!
Mikä oli pojalla mielessä? Ei toi mikään häävi oo toi sun ruostekasas, mutta auto se on, kun siinä on 4 rengasta rattia, no, moottorista puuttuu puolet ja vetävä pää on väärä. Mutta saadaan me sitä varmaan sellainen kauppakasti sulle. Voit Teimolta käydä hakee muroja ja mehua sitten.
I don't know what you're talking about, guy. Yeah, nah. Because if that part had been broken, then you would have the option of buying a replacement part. I think. Could it be as simple as an exhaust leak because one of the bolts is not tightened? I think the exhaust manifold flanges are 10mm. Nope. Were they 11? Nope. Eight, maybe. Everything here seems to be to spec. Let me see if I can peek inside the engine. See if maybe something is wrong. Crankshaft and camshaft all seems fine. I don't get it. Oil level is fine. Let me have a cigarette and think and ponder what I should do next. What I should do is go back to the store, buy some more cans of orange juice, hopefully he has some in stock, and then bottle all my moonshine and sell it to the drunk guy. If I've done it correctly, he's gonna pay me 170 per jug of moonshine, and I will get a total of 20 jugs from that one bucket of moonshine. That's enough of you. But the bottleneck is literally the bottles. Because I think I have 6 or 7 jugs of orange juice at home. And I don't know how many he's gonna have in stock, if he even has some in stock at the store. Yeah, I have my seatbelt on. Kind of hard to see my speedometer with that column mounted RPM gauge, but I can just barely make out the needle, and it looks like it's on 100, which is the speed limit. I think Perjärvi should be just around the bend. If I didn't pass, yeah, here it is. Oh, here it is.
onks tää nyt se Peräjärven kova jätkä olevina täällä?
Tell you who's a pussy ass idiot.
Onks tää mitään tehdä ja mitä tää tulee? Tää promosa kanssa tänne riehumaan.
Hi babe.
Ei vittu, me ei vittu jo.
Moro moro, mitä ei?
Hey man.
Kyllä kyllä.
Still out of juice concentrate? Dude. Do you never get anything in stock here? What the? Dude. What the fuck? These guys are insane. Yeah, I'll come back here with the tractor next time. Show you who's boss. Look at this. What the fuck? He actually dented up my car real bad. Look at this. So that guy in the yellow car is Yanni, apparently. He's an idiot. You don't have any milk yet? Do you not have anything? No wonder people are preferring to go to the Mega Marts instead of you. So that guy is apparently more friendly, but he still bumped into my car because yeah, I don't think the AI drivers are the best. Okay, let's get this thing home and hopefully not burn to death. So far, kind of an eventful episode. We drove the drunk guy home and yeah, that was it. I think bottling the Kilju and starting to sell some of it. That will have to be in the next episode, I guess. Let's see how fast can we go. Well, 6,000 RPM is the red line. Oh, temp was rising. Take it easy. At least until I get that upgraded radiator mounted. Yeah, the temp isn't going down as fast as I'd hoped. See the power lines up there, and that's the nearly home sign. Just let me turn off and onto the dirt road, and I can stop it and open the hood. I think you can actually pee into the radiator. Oh yeah. It was nearly empty. Or like, well, it was half full, but that's less than it should be. So, we have a heating issue. Or a cooling issue, rather. Let me get some more urine going. There we go, and it's full. Yeah, probably a broken head gasket. Which means I might have to pull the engine. Oh, actually, I think I can... I think I can pull the head with the engine in the car. No power now. Oh, green car guy. Did you spin out? So one of my friends who's watching the series commented to me today, actually. He asked me to explain a little bit more what the engine parts do. But I had, of course, already finished recording the building the engine part of this series. But now it looks like I have to build it again, so that's a good opportunity there. Hopefully I can keep borrowing Uncle's blue van, and that will at least give me something faster than the tractor to drive. While I'm repairing this. See how this went. Oh. So oil was almost empty. Yeah, that's not good. Empty. Yeah, I'm thinking a head gasket. Well, that's it for this episode. I will see you again and try to get some stuff fixed. What do we have here? Got lots of milk at least. Yeah. Well, goodbye and take care.